Welcome back after a dismal 2010 staging Supreme Promotions. Seek to redeem Sting this year with a series of pre and post events, but more importantly, a return to what the 28-year-old event is best known for, dancehall warfare. And we're joined right now by Sting's creator and chief organizer, CEO of Supreme Promotions, Isaiah Legg, right now on stage. Zaya.
Yes, boss.
Blessed, sir. Nice. All right, sir. So what do you conclude to be the reason for such a dismal show last year?
Well, it's several factors. Mm-hmm. Several factors. Sometimes maybe you don't even want to go all the way back into some of those things. You know, if you notice last year, we have several shows. This time last year, everybody was doing a major show, and most of them were free.
Okay.
Right? And there was this argument about Vibes Cartel. Him not being there last year, it was a factor also. Mm-hmm. Right? Because he was talking down.
But how big was that, though? That
it was a big factor. Because Movada joining him, mm-hmm, make it even worse. And they were the two big men last year.
Okay. So are you suggesting then, are you conceding that you must have the biggest names in the thing, the hottest artist at Sting for it to happen?
Yeah, but this is how it has always been. We always want to have the artists. But last year, what they talk that I said, I never did say it in that way.
Okay.
But they misconstrued and they did what they want to do.
So you're redeeming this year. What is the fix? What's the formula?
I went back to basics. Mm-hmm. Clash is what Sting was built on. Mm-hmm. And we gone right back there to the face off.
Is that to say that Sting won't happen again ever without a clash?
Not necessarily. It all depends on what the marketplace dictates. Because this year, and I want to tell you, this clash wasn't even organized by us. It was done through the artists, started by Mataran.
Yeah.
And Twin of Twin take him on, and then that was it. Everybody wanted to clash right away. Because if you're not playing a clash tune, it's like nothing is happening on the radio right now.
So the rumors of war is no longer rumors.
No.
They're real wars,
yeah,
that are coming up on the 26th.
On the 26th at Jam World.
All right. Name the clashes now.
The first one is going to be the face-off,
yes,
finals that we have in the Rhythm, Club Rhythm,
yes,
every Wednesday night. And maybe you should come one Wednesday night to see. Those clashes are streaming hot. Last night, you need to be there.
So there are two more to go.
Two more to go.
Okay.
Right. And after that, we'll have Specialists and Hurricane. Mm-hmm. Then we have Ayara, Devabrat. That is taking a lot of traction.
So lots of mini clashes going on right now.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And I don't want to call Devabrat and Ayara a mini clash. Trust me. It's
a serious surprise.
Yes, it's serious.
Okay.
And then we're going to have Mataran and Twin of Twins. Mm-hmm. Then we go to Merciless Kiprich. Mm-hmm. That's a big thing for the morning. Bounty is saying that,
okay,
he's going to call the world out. So I don't know who's going to join him.
So that one is not yet confirmed.
Right.
Because Beanie Bounty.
Beanie Bounty, because Beanie is now saying other things. And I don't know why they that choose to pick on me every year that I say things about them. I did not say anything about Beanie Man. I said things about him, mm-hmm, to big him up.
See.
But then... All the interview was not played out. So what he picked up, he thought I was dissing him. I wasn't.
Same.
But if he thinks I'm dissing him, then I'm sorry, Beanie Man. You want me to apologize? Come and do the show for the people. It's not my show anymore.
Same.
This is now an institution for the world.
Mm-hmm. And to be frank with you, I've spoken to a number of them, and they're all they're rallying,
yes,
around the show. They're saying, and Movada was there saying that we should try to save our big show.
Yes.
We don't want Sting to die. So it's from where I sit, it appears that there's a lot of support for the redemption of Sting. So I don't know. I say, well, you have time to bring around the king of the dancehall, and I'm,
yes,
sure you.
I know he's going to be coming to the show.
He will
trust
be there.
Me. He will be there.
All right. So, what are the rules of engagement? You must be using some rules now, and I suppose those rules will apply at the big night
on the
26th.
Jam World, right.
The rules you're using now at
yes, but
at Rhythm.
Those, yeah, no, not necessarily those at the Rhythm. Mm-hmm. On the stage over there, we have rules that we're going to be abiding by, mm-hmm, and we'll be talking to the artists.
So there are some special ones,
yes,
never before used,
right,
that,
right,
you'll be applying this year.
Applying over there.
Okay, so. What are you saying to patrons then? That they're safe? No bottling? No
bottle. No bottles will be served. Mm-hmm. And people should come out early because Jam World is going to be full very early. Notwithstanding what election vibes are on the corner, this is going to make the show even bigger. Mm-hmm. Because guess what? People have more money to spend. They can afford to buy a sting ticket.
So it sounds like you're very confident and you start feeling the energy already.
Yes.
Is that
yes.
the case? That
yes,
Sting
definitely.
Is back then?
It is
we could
back.
Safely say Sting is back.
It is back. I'm getting numerous calls for tickets right now.
Same.
But we don't want to go there that early.
What else is on the show? Apart from the Clash, the two big ones, the three big ones, mm-hmm. technically, and the potential being a bounty. What else is on the show? Apart from clashing.
Movado. No, we have raving, you know. It's like two things we have over there, you know.
Yes.
We have the rumors of war over that side, mm-hmm. and the raving on the other side.
Okay.
We have the gully guard. Movado. He's going to be doing like 1 hour for the people, and we're going to be working him at 1:45.
Okay.
So it's an early show for him, so people should come out and see him. And then we have the rising sensation, Popcorn. That's the Raven King. Right, and in the Raven, we have Ataru, we have Zamunda, Black Rhino, and I'm trying to remember the five young generals, that segment. Those people are the Raven people. With Movado.
Cargo.
Yeah, man, Movado. Cargo is at the Bad Rasta. It's a different segment. So we kind of divide the thing, you know. Sting do his thing different every year. We're doing.
So what about the quarter to 12 concept? Is that still alive?
No, we're not going to be doing a quarter to 12 because guess what? Mm. Most people is not going to be there at a quarter to 12 to see Movado. So we are putting him at 1:45. Mm-hmm. That everybody should be in the ground then to see the man that has really reached to this end. He's the big man right now.
The Gully God.
Yes, the Gully God.
All right.
And no apology.
Big endorsement that from Isaiah Lingen.
Yeah, he's the
big man
right
now. Okay, sir. Anything about Vibes God, a cartel situation? Any comments?
No, I don't really want to comment on that. If I think he's going back to court on the 23rd, mm-hmm. and if we do have him, it would be joy.
You wish him well, yes, and would like
wish
to have him.
Well, yes, we'd love to have him there.
Were he the not in behind bars, would he have come to the show to see?
Yes, and then we would be having a clash from him.
You
and Luna was slated to go down, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, we discussed that before he got nabbed.
Eh?
Yeah.
He would have clashed with Luna.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Price was a bit high, but we're going to do it.
But you were going to meet him.
We're going to do it.
All right, Isaiah. Well, the 26th, yes, sir.
No, and I can't leave without saying something about the other segment, the Bad Rasta segment with Ioctane and those
Yeah,
people.
Real quick, man. Yeah.
We have, from the Bad Rasta, Ioctane, Iwane, that is going to surprise over there, Cargo. He's shot.
Yes.
Trust me. Fantan Moja, Teflon, those people. He's coming from St. Mary with buses of people. And now, before I go, I must tell you that we have buses leaving all over the island. It's $3,000 for most of the locations. Take you to the show and back. And because the price of the ticket is like $1,800 and $2,000 at the gate. So $2,000 for me, $1,000 for the bus driver. It is a steal. Yes, it is.
Alright, so, but at least you're looking after your patrons.
Yes.
You're making sure they get there safe, get to and from the venue safely, and they're guaranteed transportation. That sounds good. Alright, stay with us right here on stage when we come back. Chris Martin with a world premiere. And later, one of the Bad Ras, Leng, has just spoken about right here on stage.
Oh, love, don't let me cheat on my girlfriend. Cause as far as I can see, she loves only me.